yesterday class I told you already the steel, what is the steel, and this is a man-made metal derived from the iron. Yesterday I told you already the remaining components are all small amount of other elements. This one, you see, if you observe this structure, the complete steel structure. And the steel versus cast iron, most of the people, the iron is different, steel is different. Okay, here up to 1.5% of the carbon combines with iron. More than 1.52 or 4.5% present as a free graphite known as a cast iron. Okay, the cast iron is the definition is when it is 1.5 to 4.5% is there, definitely we call it as a cast iron. Next, the properties are vary based on the carbon content. When you people increase the carbon content, it produce increase in the shear strength and also hardness. Again, it decreases the ductility and also toughness. Yeah, this is the most important thing. Types of the steels. We have different types of the steels are there based on the varying carbon content and based on the structural steel. That is one more point. The first one is the dead mild steel. So in this mild steel, the carbon content is only 0.15%. And second one, mild steel. So in this, the carbon percentage is 0.15 to 0.3%. My dear students, please observe this one. The types of the steels according to the carbon. The first one is dead mild steel. The carbon percentage is 0.15%. And the mild steel, the carbon percentage is 0.15 to 0.3%. Okay. Next, the medium carbon steel, that is the percentage is 0.3 to 0.8. High carbon steel, the percentage is 0.8 to 1.5. And cast steel or carbon steel, more than 1.5% of carbon. So according to the varying of carbon, we have these type of the steels are there. Next, the mild steel, it is a ductile and more tough, and even it is a more elastic than the cast iron, and it is more prone to rusting than the wrought iron. That means whatever previous days we are using the iron, it corrodes quickly. That's why we use the paint or enamels based on, we have different types of the items are there in the market. We use that one to reduce the corrosion, and it is easily forged and welded and riveted. And it withstand shocks or impacts as well as, that means the, as per the loads, when the equipments, heavy equipments we will use, it not much affected by the saline water, equally strong in tension and compression. Okay. And mild steel uses, where we will use the mild steel. We use as a rolled structural section like I section or T section, channel section, angle irons, plate rounds, and square rods. We are using most of the time the mild steel bars for the construction purpose. And here the MS round bars, we use this structure as a RCC structure for the round bars, whatever we discussed the previous class. Even for the MS tubes and plain and corrugated MS sheets for the, whenever we use in the roof structure, we use this mild steel also. And next, the medium carbon steel. So this medium carbon steel, we are using for the granular structures. It is more tough and elastic than the MS sheets. It is easier to harden and temper. It is more difficult to forge and weld, but normal one, it is very easy to forge. And it is stronger in compression than the tension or in shear, okay? Medium carbon steel, where we will use this medium carbon? For making tools such as drills, files, chisels, and also making parts that are very hard, tough, and durable, and capable of withstand shocks and vibration. So these medium carbon steels we use in the, whenever the durability point of view or tough point of view, or when the instruments are heavily we are using in the industry, at that time we have to use to withstand the shocks and vibrations coming from the equipment. At that time, we are using the medium carbon steel. And also high carbon steel. The high carbon steel is, it increased tensile strength leads to less weight. So the structure becomes lighter when we use this one. It resists the corrosion is very better compared to previous two types of the steels. Okay, and it is more brittle and less ductile. Okay, in reinforcing precast concrete structure, we use this high carbon. Okay, next. So anyway, we have according to the elements, we have different types are there. Like that, you know. According to the elements, we have carbon steels are there and alloy steels are there. Carbon steels and alloy steels. We have two types. The steels that owe their properties due to carbon, we call it as a carbon steel. Steels with properties due to elements other than carbon, we call it as a alloy steel. Like we have two types of the steels are there. So these are the major important thing where the alloy steels. Okay, we are divided into two types. That is the ferrous alloys, non-ferrous alloys. Okay. Next, this is the stress strain curve for the steel. You people already know this one. No need of explanation again and again in the strength of materials and RCC. You people learned a lot. Okay. So the mild steel grade is 43, high tensile steel grade 50. That is a Fe430 and Fe500. So if you observe here, this is the elastic range up to here, and up to here, this is the plastic range. So this is elastic range, plastic range, and strain hardening range, and also knuckling and failure. Failure will start here. That means your member will in elastic range, plastic range. Anyway, this type of the steel.